Hello, podcast listeners. We know podcasts are a great way to catch up on a program that you may have missed on KSJE, and it's provided as a free service of this radio station. But you know, KSJE is now listener-supported, and so while you enjoy this podcast, we hope that you'll also take some time to join KSJE. Become a member today. It's quite easy to do. Just go to our website at ksje.com/support and pick the level of support that best matches your budget. Thanks again for listening. Here's your podcast. KSJE is supported by San Juan Regional Medical Center, your community hospital with a rich heritage that dates back to before New Mexico was a state. We've been improving the health of the Four Corners since 1910. As a nonprofit hospital, San Juan Regional Medical Center is a values-driven organization. We strive to deliver on our mission to personalize health care and create vitality and enthusiasm in healing. We are here for you when you need us, offering a comprehensive range of inpatient, outpatient, and emergency care services. Wednesday morning on KSJE, it is time for our weekly trip to the Encouragement Lab, and this week the lab has come to us. Look who's here in our studio. It is Dr. Mike Hattabaugh. Good morning.
Good morning, Scott. How are you doing?
I am well. It's nice to see you actually in person.
Yeah.
I was just live and breathe.
You got the HD on the face. I don't look as pretty in your camera.
Well, mine, so. It's still great to see you.
No, I do have a nice
little tan line there.
My daughter says I look like the Incredibles with the tan line.
I like that. Yeah. You've been wearing your sunglasses when you've been out and about. So yes. Anyway, welcome. So you are here on campus this week for a day or two.
Yeah, presenting at a conference, the Connect Conference.
Yes.
Yeah, so, I think you had Pamela
we did,
Drake on.
Right, the Creating Cultural Harmony Conference.
Right.
And so that was yesterday. And so this morning we are talking about courage.
Courage.
Right.
Yes, how to have courage. So I learned something about courage.
It's a tall order for some of us.
Maybe. Yeah. Some of your listeners are probably Brene Brown fans. Which she's a very popular Oprah kind of figure right now in the self-help kind of genre. I was listening to a book of hers actually driving up to the airport the other day, and she talked about the fact that we have changed the definition of courage. That courage used to mean something different than it means now. Now it kind of means heroic and you know, you got to save somebody's life to have courage.
Okay,
but the real definition of the word originally was courage meant to share yourself, share your opinions, to be brave, to step up and say, no, I disagree.
Right.
And we're kind of losing that. Not a lot of people have courage anymore. We're either bullied by people who tell us what they say, and we just kind of shut up and we go vote a certain way or a different way, or we just say, you know what, I'm not getting involved in that. So, you know, think of the phrase, the courage of your convictions.
Right, true.
And that's really what it means. And that, you know, if you want to be courageous, you've got to take risks with what you say. Now, that doesn't mean being mean. It doesn't mean you become that bully like everybody else. And that's, you know, you watch, you know, that's why I love doing radio, even though it's visual radio now.
Right.
Is radio is about much more about solving problems, about digging into the issues, and TV is about just fighting and entertainment.
In many cases,
I think
that's true.
Yeah.
Yes. Right.
Yeah, and so the idea behind that being is you can have a conversation on radio where you're truly able to say, so we disagree on this, or we have this, as opposed to, you know, the red meat of some of the political talk shows that are just, you know, I'm going to yell at you and you yell at me. Well, that's not courage. Courage is saying, let me tell you how I feel, and then you hear that, and then you tell me how you feel, and we go, okay, so how can we solve this issue together?
Right.
Even though we come at it from two different value systems or whatever.
And might I say, maybe even a compromise?
Oh, wow, that's a dirty word.
Right, well, that's why I was a little hesitant to even bring it up in mixed company here on our radio program.
Heaven forbid we compromise.
Right.
I mean, and I get it. You know, some things aren't compromisable, but if we think about it right now in America, politically, it seems like nothing's compromisable.
It's one way or the highway,
and
I think.
Yeah, we keep splitting the baby, per se, and then the baby doesn't live.
Right.
At some point, you have to say, it's okay if we figure out.
Would that be a sign of courage if I give up a little bit of my point of view to try to compromise with you?
You know, it should be, Scott, but unfortunately in the political scene right now, it's a sign of weakness.
Yeah.
Or at least that's the way it's couched.
Right.
It used to be a sign. Now, I get it. Some of that is institutionalism has brought upon itself a lot of corruption. Right. A lot of bad has come out of that. You know, it's let's compromise as long as I get paid.
Right. I don't want to be the first one to do it. You go first.
And right.
Kind of a,
right.
And then you say you go first.
And it's, again,
no one ever goes first.
You know, you realize that another word, you know, the legal term is quid pro quo, right? That's
right.
Compromise.
Yes.
Little for you, little for me.
Right.
The old Latin in that. And real compromise is saying, hey, we disagree on this, so let's meet in the middle. Neither one of us is going to be happy, but we're going to get something out of it. I think of several issues in the past that where because we didn't compromise, you know, we end up getting things that we didn't like.
Right, true.
And, you know, I think a lot of issues that where you know, because there's no compromise, then nobody gets anything. And that's a basic communication principle is,
right.
I'm okay, you're not okay, but if I can't be okay, I want it to be win-lose, but if it can't be win-lose, it's going to be lose-lose.
Lose-lose, yeah.
And it's really hard to say win-win.
Right. And well, that's another show, I guess. Why is that? That's another show.
Yeah.
We don't have time for that one. All right. Dr. Hattabaugh, great to see you.
Good to see you.
Thanks for being here.
All right. Great to be in your studio. And
thank you. Yes. This is your first appearance here, is it not? Right?
I'll work on my tan lines.
Okay.
Come a little prettier next time.
We'll send you to makeup and hair and makeup before you come in next time.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. Dr. Mike Hattabaugh, he is with me every Wednesday right here on KSJE Farmington. Did you enjoy that podcast? We hope that you did. And if you did, share it with your friends. And if you really want to keep podcasts like this coming, please support KSJE. You can do it easily online at ksje.com.